Let's see how to install a desktop environment on Windows Subsystem for Linux. I'll start by opening the Windows terminal. And let's start by listing all of the WSL distros we currently have. This can be done by WSL-L. And as we can see, I currently have only one distro, Ubuntu. And as you can see, this is the default. So if I click here on the little arrow, I'm going to be able to find it here. Here it is, Ubuntu. So let's start it. And the Ubuntu virtual machine was started inside WSL. Next, we need to make sure that our distro is up to date. So first, we run sudo apt update. And once this is done, we run sudo apt upgrade -y. So our system is now up to date. Next, I want us to install Tasksel. Tasksel is a small application that helps us install, among other things, desktop environments. So to install Tasksel, we're simply going to run apt install Tasksel. So for me, it was already installed, so it didn't install anything new. But in your case, it's probably going to take a minute or so. Anyway, now that we have Tasksel installed, let's run it. And we have to run Tasksel with sudo. So sudo Tasksel. And here we can choose which desktop environment we want. You can use the arrows to move up and down. So move the cursor to the desktop environment you want. So if, for example, you want XFCE, just move the cursor over there. And to make your selection, you need to press on the spacebar. And as you can see, when I press on the spacebar, I get this star next to the desktop environment I want to install. I don't want XFCE, I want KDE Plasma. And here it is. And as you can see, I already have here the asterisk. And that's because I already installed KDE Plasma. Now, I strongly recommend to only install one desktop environment. Installing more than one can cause all kinds of clashes and problems. If you want to test more than one, just do it on another virtual machine. Anyway, here are our options. So we have GNOME, XFCE, GNOME Flashback, and then we have KDE Plasma, Cinnamon, and we also have Mate, LXDE, and LXQT. So make your selection and then hit Tab. And when OK is highlighted, press Enter. So for me, I didn't choose anything new, so nothing happens. But if your virtual machine doesn't have a desktop environment yet, and then you choose one from Tasksel, it's going to be installed now. Now, the download and installation of a desktop environment is quite heavy and time-consuming, so you're going to need some patience. But eventually, it will be completed. Once the installation of the desktop environment is done, we need to install the remote desktop server. So for that, we'll install XRDP. So sudo apt install XRDP. And once again, it's already installed for me, so nothing new was installed. We now need to check the IP address of our virtual machine, and we can do that using IPA. So here's the IP of my virtual machine. And we should be able to use it to connect to the desktop environment of this machine. So let's start Windows Remote Desktop Client. And here I'll type in the IP address of the virtual machine. And let's connect. And we need to provide the username for the Linux machine and also the password. And establishing the connection might take a while. And I need to type in my password once again. And that's it. We now have a fully functional Linux machine with a desktop environment.